Right, U.S. laws on self-defense, gun control and racism need revamping, according to the country's attorney general. Cities across the U.S. have seen angry protests in the past few days over the controversial acquittal of George Zimmerman, a Florida Neighborhood Watch volunteer who killed black teenager Trayvon Martin last year. It was ruled to be self-defense, even though Martin was unarmed. Solomon Comissiong, host and founder of a Your World News radio program, which focuses on social issues, joins us live for more perspective. Right. How do you feel about this ruling, Mr. Comissiong?
I feel the same way so many people of color in this country feel about this ruling. It's a complete injustice, but to put things in perspective, it is business as usual in the U.S. People of color have routinely been on the losing end of the stick when it comes to police brutality, when it comes to whether it's vigilantes, neighborhood watchmen, perpetrating the crimes and outright killing black youth, black men, black women. Routinely, time and time again, the perpetrators, the murderers, are you know, they're let go scot-free, or at the very, you know, or at the very most, they're giving some kind of slap on the wrist, where we saw Johan Mezelis, the police officer that shot Oscar Grant in Oakland, California, in the back. You know, he did little more than a year for killing this young black man in cold blood, and it was caught on camera. So I'm completely outraged, but frankly, I'm not too surprised given the complexity of race relations in America and the fabric within this society that is riddled with institutional racism.
From what I understand from what you're saying and what many argue, that this case depicts U.S. racial profiling. How do you think the system needs to be changed, if that's the case?
Well, I think the system, in order to be changed, it can't be because some folks say, oh, it's, you know, well, not all police officers or not all, you know, neighborhood watchmen are bad. But that's not the case. I mean, if it was just a few bad police officers or neighborhood watchmen, if that was the case, then it would be easy to try to root out and remove these folks from their jurisdictions. But it is a systematic problem. It is an issue. And so in order for this to change, the entire system has to be revamped. It has to be deconstructed to be reconstructed. There have to be complete responsibilities given to communities, especially communities of color, to have oversight when it comes to whether it's neighborhood watch or the police in general.
Is this a case about racial tensions within the country, or is this more about a gun control debate, or is it both?
I think this is a case for, it has to, well, first and foremost, it's unequivocally a case that has to do with racial tensions. It has to, but more deeply, it's a case of institutional racism. It's a case of black people routinely being targeted by the police, by vigilantes. And I want to point out, because this is something that the media virtually ignored last year, the Malcolm X grassroots movement put out an extensive report that pointed out, that showed that last year in 2012, at the very least, 313 black people were killed in the United States by the police, by neighborhood watchmen, by vigilantes, or so-called security guards. That's one every 28 hours. That was virtually ignored. And the vast majority of those people were unarmed. And so this shows you, this is an epidemic. This is nothing new. This is an epidemic, and that's why anything less than a complete revamping of the system, anything less than a complete attention placed on this, placed on eviscerating these kinds of injustices, is nothing short of an injustice itself.
Will the public anger subside after a while, or will there be far more reaching repercussions following the verdict of this trial?
Well, I'm hoping it doesn't subside. I mean, recent history tells us that unfortunately, because of all the bells and whistles and distractions that continue to occupy the minds of so many different Americans, that, you know, folks hit their apex. Just like, for instance, when the Trayvon Martin murder itself came to light, you know, by way of black activists and black journalists bringing it to light and forcing the so-called corporate media to pay attention to it, people reached an apex, and then it kind of dropped. And I'm hoping this time that folks continue to remain vigilant and consistent about this, because it's only consistency is the only thing that is going to give us the chance to change the system. And it only takes a consistent critical mass. It was 1% of the U.S. population that was actively involved in the civil rights era. And we see what kind of impact that made. So a critical mass that is consistent about this day in and day out, week in and week out, month in and month out, I think they can have positive ramifications and change the system to be something that is actually humane and just.
Solomon Comissiong, social activist and host of Your World News radio program. Thank you for your thoughts on this story.
Thank you.